Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the 2021 San Diego State University All University Convocation. I'm Brittany Santos-Sterig, President De La Torre's Chief of Staff. I could not be more excited to start today's program, and we have so much good news to share throughout the next hour. But first, before we can get started, it is my pleasure to introduce SDSU's tribal liaison, Mr. Jacob Alvarado Waipuk, who will Jacob will provide the Kumeyaay land acknowledgement for San Diego State University.
Thank you. Hagui Bema, Noskana Netsuhi, Mati Pai Kumeyaay, and Yashmoth Waipuk, Nipum Mukatlas Kopai. My name is Jacob. I'm Ipai, that means people. And I'm from Samoscore Reservation. My clan is Waipuk, and I'm going to read the land acknowledgement in a good way to honor the Kumeyaay Nation that have been here for thousands of years. So, with that being said, thank you for having me here. And we stand upon a land that carries the footsteps of millennia of Kumeyaay people. They are people whose traditional life ways intertwine with the worldview of earth and sky and a community of living beings. This land is part of a relationship that has nourished, healed, protected, and embraced the Kumeyaay people to the present day. It is part of a worldview founded in the harmony of the cycles of the sky and balance and forces of life. For the Kumeyaay, the red and black represent the balance of those forces that provide for harmony within our bodies as well as the world around us. As students, faculty, staff, and alumni of San Diego State University, we acknowledge this legacy from the Kumeyaay. We promote this balance in life as understanding. We find inspiration in the Kumeyaay spirit to open our minds and hearts. It is a legacy of the red and black. It is land of the Kumeyaay. Yechun, my heart is good. Nawum.
Thank you, Jacob. I would now like to welcome again our guests joining us today in person and also virtually. No matter where you are, thank you for being a part of our Aztec family. I would also like to recognize our new faculty and staff. We are pleased to welcome you to our San Diego State University family and to see many of you for the first time, even if we hired you 18 months ago, in person for the first time this year. SDSU is a wonderful and exciting place to work, to learn, to teach, and to do research. We look forward to your leadership, your creativity, and the energy that you will bring to our campus community. Our wish is that your years at San Diego State will be both productive and rewarding for you, and we extend our most sincere welcome to you all. Thank you to our new faculty and staff. I'd also like to acknowledge some of our university leaders and the distinguished guests joining us today. We have our members of the Council of Vice Presidents, our Academic Dean's Council, and our Associated Students, Executive Officers. Could you all please rise and be acknowledged? Thank you for joining us. I'd also like to acknowledge our other guests joining us on stage. We have our librarian and University Senate Chair, Will Weston. Our President of Associated Students, Ashley Tejada. We have the President of the SDSU Alumni Board of Directors, Charlotte Ochiki. We have the Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, Salvador Hector Ochoa. And of course, we have President Adela De La Torre. We are also joined by the 8 recipients of the SDSU Alumni Distinguished Faculty Award and the inaugural recipient of the SDSU Staff Lifetime Achievement Award. Please join me in welcoming them. We will get to know a lot more about our awardees shortly. So last year was a year of achievement for our SDSU community, and we'll now be able to share a short video that celebrates some of these moments before President De La Torre provides her opening convocation address.
We are San Diego State University, a global community of students, faculty, and staff deeply committed to the public good. And our future is bright as our university is becoming a national model for social mobility and public value and is accelerating economic and workforce impact. We are an academic and research powerhouse devoted to discovery. We are entering the second year of our strategic plan, which is putting SDSU research on a significant growth trajectory. Researchers are leading projects to develop better batteries for electric cars, reduce disease among the Latinx community, combat climate change, and so much more. Support for HSI programs doubled, and we launched several new centers, including the Center for Human Rights. The Big Ideas Initiative is also leveraging our distinctive research strengths for the betterment of the world. And we are combating COVID-19 head-on with more than 50 research projects funded by more than $10 million, with projects often in San Diego's most vulnerable communities. The impact our faculty and staff experts have had on curbing the spread of COVID-19 and increasing vaccine uptake is remarkable. It was also an outstanding year for faculty accomplishments. SDSU engineers Riza Akavian, Sean Park, and John Fei Shi each received the prestigious NSF Career Award, and overall, five researchers received NIH's Competitive Career Award. Also, SDSU continues to expand support and degree access to include efforts at SDSU Imperial Valley, SDSU Global Campus, and through new microsites with local community colleges. What is now the Department of Women's Studies, the first of its kind when it launched in the 70s, just celebrated its 50-year anniversary. The School of Public Health, a pillar of San Diego's healthcare network, providing more than 75% of the region's healthcare workforce, celebrated its 40th anniversary. And donors continue to give at record rates. Last year, $133 million was raised in support of SDSU faculty, staff, and students. We are building for sustainability and for a lasting future. In July, SDSU and Clark Construction Group hosted a ceremony where the final steel beam for Aztec Stadium was put into place. More than 6,000 new jobs will support the project, and stadium construction is on schedule for completion in fall 2022. We are closer than ever to realizing SDSU Mission Valley, including its innovation district. With the retail, hotel, and housing, the project is poised to grow SDSU's already strong economic impact by adding another $3 billion annually to the region. SDSU Mission Valley buildings will be designed to achieve or exceed LEED Silver. Meanwhile, our newest residential community, Washiakok, earned another LEED Gold certification. We are a community for all, and we find meaningful opportunities to honor our diversity and achievements. We made new investments in our library holdings and special collections to include an expanded focus on the histories, cultures, and languages of diverse communities. Just this year, SDSU was recognized both as a first-gen forward advisory institution and an age-friendly university, designations that collectively recognize our commitment to serving individuals throughout one's lifespan. And we honored 2020 and 2021 graduates in a first-ever commencement at Petco Park and a commencement at SDSU Imperial Valley. These in-person events were all the more touching after 14 months of predominantly virtual instruction. We have much more to celebrate, and our future is bright. This season, the men's basketball team won its second consecutive outright Mountain West regular season title and was ranked 16th in the final AP Top 25 poll. The Aztecs Rock Hunger fundraiser collected nearly 345,000 pounds of food, benefiting a local food bank and an on-campus pantry. And SDSU alumni are achieving greatness. Destin Daniel Cretton is directing Marvel's Shang-Chi, Xander Schaufele won Olympic gold, and County of San Diego Public Health Officer Dr. Wilma Wooten was named San Diegan of the Year. Looking forward, we will welcome about 35,000 students this fall, along with nearly 50 new faculty members, a record 20 new academic advisors, and 8 new mental health counselors. And our students are poised for success. SDSU's six-year graduation rate increased to 79%, with several colleges well exceeding 80% each year. SDSU is on track to fully eliminate many equity gaps by 2025. Next year, we will celebrate our 125th anniversary, the same year the football team takes on the University of Arizona Wildcats on September 3rd, 2022, in the new Aztec Stadium. Our global SDSU community has and continues to be successful because of our curiosity, our creativity, our courage, and our commitment to one another. No matter where we are one.
Please welcome San Diego State University's president, Dr. Adela De La Torre.
Buenos dias and good morning. Bienvenidos and welcome to our 2021 convocation. It's incredible for me to believe that I'm entering my fourth year as your president. Time has rapidly passed by. It has certainly felt for many of us like decades, given these last 18 months. Nonetheless, my enthusiasm for SDSU's aspirations and possibilities have not waned. And as another school year begins, my hope is that we launch with even more excitement for our future. It is wonderful to be here together, face to face, heart to heart, and back to this beautiful campus, despite the ebb and flow of uncertainty and the questions that have plagued us during these last few months. The pandemic is not over, we all know that, but we are vaccinated at high rates and we are wiser about avoiding the risks. Our thoughtful actions make a difference. Moreover, I marvel at the great capacity of our staff, faculty, and students to nimbly respond when we are forced to alter a course of action for the sake of the community's collective good. Because of all this, our university is stronger and more resilient than ever. This period has shown us something we already knew. We can succeed and we can flourish no matter the obstacles. Because in the 124-year history of this great university community, we've done it again and again. The start of another academic year is a time to imagine new possibilities and adventures. First and foremost, we are the transborder university of the region, of the state, and of the nation. No other U.S. university can claim stewardship of the complete border region of the state. From the Pacific to the Imperial Valley, our campus creates the intellectual hub for learning, research, and community engagement. Our regional impact through our Georgian program similarly spans and impacts the entire country and its global border region. Our strong programs and groundbreaking research are only as limited as our imaginations and appetite for hard work. So we welcome 2021-22 academic year with tremendous enthusiasm. We look forward to what we can achieve together, to what we can learn from one another, and to how we can impact the lives of each other, the region, and the world. When I reflect on the last year and a half, I can honestly say that our willingness to collectively break down barriers in teaching and research allowed us to survive and thrive during this period. We embraced new ways to collaborate and support each other. We were fluid as we came together through our ever-changing environments, and we transformed work and teaching in ways we could not have imagined before the pandemic. Consider for a moment the extraordinary partnership our 40-year-old School of Public Health forged with the San Diego County Department of Health and Human Services and the broader community to fight this pandemic. They advanced contact tracing for tens of thousands with a particular emphasis on San Diego County's underserved communities. That collaboration directly helped our university and the region make real progress against the virus and save lives. Donors to San Diego State University also worked to enhance lives this year, giving $133 million to our students and faculty and making an all-time annual record for the university. And more than $5 million of this giving came from our own faculty and staff. Today, each one of us is still out in the community, active, fully engaged, and making a difference. SDSU has those values deeply embedded in our mission. Without a doubt, SDSU is deeply embedded in the San Diego community. And although this may be a common refrain for us, it is unique within the context of a nationally recognized public research university. And during the past 18 months, this purpose became crystal clear. Our health is our community's health. Our assets are the community's assets. While each of us may pursue our individual goals and accomplishments, we also come to understand that our greatest satisfaction and reward comes in the service of something bigger and greater than ourselves. I've been in higher education for over 30 years. We've all seen universities obsess over ratings, rankings, and best of lists. Certainly, we enjoy strong state and national rankings at SDSU, but more than that, we value people and the tangible, positive change we are creating. We can be the world's model for a public transborder university. Many UCs, CSUs, and public universities in Arizona and elsewhere have individual projects or programs focused on border issues, but few have regional prominence and faculty expertise like SDSU, which can create the synergistic elements needed to leverage these relationships for sustainable and integrated impact on shared issues and problems. It is distinct, and it is defining. Moreover, our faculty, staff, and alumni strive to make the world a better place in tangible ways every day. We work to see every student who steps into our campus graduate with a passion, motivation, and skills they will need to compete today and in the future. And we accomplish all that when we break down barriers, when we connect with one another, and when we avoid remaining in our own silos. It is human nature to connect with others, to be in community, and foster community in others. If we had any doubt about that before the pandemic, we have no doubt about it now. A month ago, just as many of us were returning to campus for the first time in 17 months, we had a ceremony at SDSU Mission Valley. Community members, construction workers, engineers, many of whom are SDSU alumni, came together to celebrate placement of the final steel beam on top of the new multipurpose stadium rising from the ground. This building and the campus expansion it unlocks represents the economic engine that will propel us into a dynamic new future rich with opportunities. With the revenues these amenities will generate, we are freeing ourselves from the ups and downs of the state funding cycle and opening the door to a state-of-the-art mixed-use campus expansion. To innovation, new housing, more students, enhanced research, thousands of jobs, and more than $3 billion a year in new economic activity. As I watched people gather for that live event, I was struck by how happy they were to see each other again. People wanted to linger and talk. They yearned to reconnect after being apart for so long. These social instincts are part of our human character. At San Diego State University, we are committed to this work of breaking down barriers and making connections. It's in our DNA as a transborder university. We know in our hearts and minds the importance of bridging divides and bringing people and ideas together for the greater good. And we must. We must continue pushing these boundaries. We must integrate across departments, across borders. We must be transdisciplinary and prepare our students to be transdisciplinary, because today's workforce demands it. Our region demands it. The problems of today and tomorrow demand it. The monumental challenges of our age, climate change, homelessness, racial and social inequity, health disparities, cannot be solved by innovating in one area, nor can they be solved by one community, one department, one university, one system, or one country alone. Our chance for success only increases when we move away from the model that says the individual is king, towards a more integrative and transborder model of community, collaboration, and cooperation. We see this need across our nation. America is deeply divided. We limit ourselves every day by our stubborn devotion to separateness and isolating one group from another, by creating a separate hierarchy of privilege and need when we can truly become more empowered and successful by fusing these needs. When we come together without walls that separate us, we are a force to be reckoned with, and we discover that we are more connected and more in touch with the admirable aspects of our character. The development in Mission Valley and our expansion in Imperial Valley underscores what I mean. In Mission Valley, our vision for the land that we purchased from the city just 1 year ago was not handed down from on high. That inspired vision came up from the community. It was a citizens' initiative first, and so it was a region's will as a collective that lifted that final steel beam last month, when no one expected this much progress so quickly. And it will be the collective will of San Diego State community that makes the next phase of Mission Valley a flagship for entrepreneurial partnerships and for integrative research and learning. I'm delighted to say that this project is moving forward in record time, because when you have the collaboration, coordination, and will of the community behind you, glorious things can happen. Our vision in Imperial Valley is also unmatched. We will grow our capacity and start graduating the engineers and professionals that the regional workforce demands. I've met with local leaders, business and industry innovators, and all are clear: a professional, highly skilled local workforce is needed by all and will dramatically accelerate economic growth and minimize income inequality. And by creating this more dynamic workforce, it is possible to accelerate new industries, which diversifies the economy of the valley. As the only four-year public institution in the region, we not only have the potential, we also have the responsibility. And recently, we have started to make good on this. Just last year, our faculty introduced the first STEM major in mathematics. We added new graduate programs starting this fall. And in collaboration with our College of Engineering, we're pursuing ideas for the build-out of 200 acres of land in Brawley, connected with the development of Innovation District and the untapped potential of renewable and alternative energy, and its connections with climate change and the Salton Sea. And our SDSU Global Campus is expanding access to working students throughout the region and the world through many of our programs, such as microsites at community colleges. This was not done in a vacuum, nor from the perspective of one institution or one program or one individual. All of these strategies amplify access and were the direct result of consultation, collaboration, and new partnerships across systems that forge our capacity to meet the needs from the shared perspectives of all. Simply put, what we are doing is not just about inclusion. It is about true participation and a fusion of ideas across systems and constituencies. This is what makes our One San Diego State University special and is included in our strategic plan, where we are transcending borders and transforming lives. When we launched the plan last fall, we were in the midst of a global pandemic and reeling from the devastating economic downturn that came with it. It was May 2020, and our strategic plan committee faced a decision. Can we still launch and live this plan? Can we still push forward when the future is so uncertain? Like everyone else, we were distracted by the public health crisis. But the principles we identified together, and which are reflected in our strategic plan, are more resilient than any disruption, even a disruption of pandemic magnitude. They reflect the core principles of our 124-year university community and the voices of thousands. They represent the hopes and aspirations of all those who have called SDSU home and who see themselves in its future. I believed wholeheartedly in the strength of that plan when we completed it, and I believe in it even more today. Our strategic plan will steer us toward our North Star, becoming the world's best transnational university that is value-driven and which is expansive, inclusive, and dynamic. As a great public research institution, how we build for that future must incorporate what we have learned these past months. Indeed, as I have stated earlier, we cannot lose this capacity to remain nimble, thoughtful, and innovative to meet the pressing challenge of accelerating access and equity. At SDSU, the ability to adjust, succeed, integrate, and connect our community infuses our strategic plan. It is all about becoming a premier public research university focused on access, excellence, and impact. Being resilient enough to flourish no matter how we are challenged. expanding our global impact through a common mission and identity that unites all our campuses and communities, promoting equity and inclusion in everything we do, and by embracing our identity as a defining transborder Hispanic-serving institution, and cultivating a university culture and infrastructure that supports a truly student-centered campus. As we usher in this new academic year with enthusiasm and hope, and as we stay connected and committed to the greater good, I have no doubt San Diego State University community will continue to thrive. Thank you all so very much for what you are, for what you do in service to our community. Mil gracias.
Thank you, President De La Torre. It is now my privilege to recognize the recipients of this year's Presidential Staff Excellence Award. If you don't already know these fine individuals, I encourage you to greet them and get to know them. They are your mentors, they are your partners, they are your colleagues. They are also a wonderful group who collectively represent what is best about San Diego State University. Today, our awardees are joining us both in person and virtually. For those of you in the room with us, can you please stand when I call your name? And can we hold our applause until all are introduced? This year's Team Effort Award is the group behind the Virtual Faculty Instruction Technology Center, or FIT, which launched in March 2020 as we found ourselves forced almost overnight into virtual instruction. Here we recognize Chris Clemens, Sean Howes, Leo Lopez, Michelle Peterson, and Aurora Valesco. Our honoree for community service is Domenico Villa, an outreach specialist in the Office of Educational Outreach Programs and Ethnic Affairs. Nico works closely with Morse, Lincoln, and San Diego high schools, which all serve heavily underrepresented areas and where, because of his work, we are seeing an increase of applications across the board to San Diego State University. Thank you. Our honoree for service to the university is Kathy Chavez, Administrative Support Coordinator for the School of Exercise and Nutritional Sciences. Kathy played an essential role in the planning for the extensive environmental improvements in the ENS labs, a vital part of the school's research and teaching missions and other workspace. Thank you, Kathy. In the auxiliary support category, we have Peter Delaney, IT Security and Operations Manager for the SDSU Research Foundation. At the outset of the pandemic, his planning led to the easy transition from work to home, easier for some than others. Peter has been a resource across campus, though, especially on critical matters of security, and he has helped to fend off IT breaches and fraud all year long. Thank you, Peter. In the innovation category, we recognize Greg Elliott, Director of Mass Spectrometry and Major Equipment for the Chemistry and Biochemistry Departments. Greg led a realignment of the department in response to COVID-19, and he watched over all the critical equipment that needed regular attention to remain functional in person. He has also worked to ensure remote access to these instruments by students throughout the pandemic. And our final honorees are Manager of the Year. And we are fortunate to have two recipients this year. Libby barely needs an introduction, but I will introduce her regardless. She received multiple nominations from colleagues across campus, and it is easy to see why. Libby Skiles became a name known to everyone across campus as the Director of Student Health Services, standing at the front line of the battle against an evolving and deadly pathogen just 8 months after she arrived at SDSU. Every day, she continues to work to keep the campus aware and informed and safe about this continuing threat, and most importantly, how to protect ourselves and others. Thank you, Libby. recognize our second award winner of Manager of the Year, Sharika White. Sharika White is our Associate Director of the Educational Opportunity Programs and Ethnic Affairs, and it's in this position that she presents a welcoming and supportive face of SDSU to all our prospective students, our admitted students, and the students who are joining us this year. Last year, Sharika launched the Harold K. Brown Knowledge, Education, and Empowerment Program to support Black students at SDSU, her own alma mater. She oversees a long list of additional engagement, outreach, recruitment, and retention programs, which she has maintained tirelessly these last 18 months. Once again, I want you to join me in thanking and congratulating Sharika White. It is now my pleasure to introduce University Senate Chair Dr. Will Weston.
Thank you, Brittany. And good morning to everyone. On behalf of the faculty, staff, students, and administrators who serve in the University Senate, along with my fellow officers, Vice Chair Nola Butler Byrd, Secretary Jose Preciado, Treasurer Amanda Fuller, and Parliamentarian Bill Eady, it is my pleasure as Senate Chair to welcome you to our 124th academic year. I am also pleased to welcome our new faculty and staff and welcome everyone else back to campus as we thoughtfully return to campus after a year and a half of working remotely through the COVID health crisis, together but apart. This past year and a half has been especially challenging for the nation, SDSU, and each of us individually. Issues of diversity and equity have been a focal point for the nation and SDSU. The murder of George Floyd, the undermining of voting rights, white supremacy, continued attacks on the equal rights for women and LGBTQI people, rising nationalism, and a political dialogue that has been intolerant and illiberal and an undemocratic discourse. All while we lived, struggled, and worked resolutely through a global pandemic. Additionally, this year, we have begun to experience some of the most dramatic impacts to our environment, our economy, and our health due to human-made climate change. The destruction of Leighton in British Columbia, the forest fires raging in Siberia, record high temperatures across North America, record-breaking fires in the American West, another active Atlantic hurricane season, and increased economic and state instability worldwide as we adapt to our increasing volatile environmental and economic reality. All of these challenges have created new pressing uncertainties. And as we face these new uncertainties, they will be reflected in how we teach, research, learn, work, solve problems, socialize, and build communities. However, even though we have so many challenges ahead of us, I want to still offer a message of optimism. Your very presence, your attendance, the work you do, the community that you build here at SDSU is a testament to our shared resilience and commitment to a cause, a mission much larger than ourselves. SDSU is an important, amazing, and unique academic community composed of our campus here on the Mesa, campuses in the Imperial Valley, Republic of Georgia, and now our new campus in Mission Valley. I hope you all become as proud as I am to be a part of SDSU and a part of our ambitious enterprise of learning, knowledge creation, and cultivating social justice. Optimism. Persistent, tireless, hopeful optimism has defined our character as an institution for generations and inspired us to come together as a community, as engaged and compassionate global citizens. Our faculty are recognized around the world for their innovative research, scholarship, creative activity, and clinical practices. our dedicated staff who work tirelessly to keep the university and university infrastructure functioning for us all. Our students who join our faculty and staff in this work will go on to help shape our future. Together, as a unique community defined by our diversity, our commitment to inclusivity, our demonstrated resilience, our tremendous human compassion, and our unflagging optimism, we will meet all of these challenges. In closing, I want to recognize our SDSU campuses are on Kumeyaay land. In our SDSU land acknowledgement, we say, for the Kumeyaay, red and black represent the balance of these forces that provide for harmony within our bodies as well as the world around us. So, as we pursue our goals of knowledge and learning, we should honor the wisdom of the Kumeyaay and do so harmoniously, respectfully, and honestly. Welcome. Welcome to San Diego State University. Finally, it's one of the great benefits of my position is the opportunity to work with student leaders. I'm so impressed by their dedication to SDSU and their eagerness to engage their student colleagues and the larger community. It is also this unrelenting motivation that helps them balance their academics with their duties as officers. I now have the good fortune to introduce one of those student leaders, Ashley Tejada, President of Associated Students. Ashley is a post-secondary educational leadership graduate student who recently graduated from SDSU with a bachelor's degree in English and a minor in leadership. Please join me in welcoming Ashley Tejada.
Thank you, Dr. Weston. Good morning and welcome. It is an honor and privilege to be speaking today as Associated Students President and on behalf of our SDSU students. We are entering a time of uncertainty, a time of adjustment, and a time of adversity coming back onto this campus. But more than anything, we are entering a time of limitless potential. We have shown that throughout our students, our staff, our faculty, and our administration, we have grown to have more experiences in common than we ever would have thought. I'm not referring to Zoom exhaustion, to social disconnect, or to the struggle of unstable environments, although all of those may be true. I'm referring to the adaptability, perseverance, heart, and passion that brought us all back here today. Together, we do not just aim for a smooth return, but we strive to return even better than before. Associated Students is empowered by this concept, not just rising above all of the trauma, burden, and obstruction this last year and a half has caused, but utilizing these times and experiences to create a momentum when moving forward, and a big one at that. San Diego State University is impossible to duplicate, a large reason being that students, faculty, staff, and administration collaborate constantly in order to accomplish more. This has never been more apparent than in this moment where we are surrounded by one another where 6 months ago it never seemed possible. Which is why this year, Associated Students is excited to introduce the Year of Community. Now, the unity ending is an uppercase because we know that stepping back onto campus, progress, change, advocacy, and pride is best achieved when we are all united. From our students to faculty to staff to administration, this year is here to be embraced. Now, the tagline is what I hold closest to my heart. It starts with us. Because any one person can aim for unity with their entire being, but it takes multiple to actually achieve it. I'm proud to share our pillars this year that I genuinely believe can be adopted by every person on this campus and speak to the same standard of partnership. The first being, execute shared governance through proactive collaboration and communication opportunities. We take pride in being a CSU that strives for the student voice in each and every setting. The second, elevate the importance of mental health and overall healing. Throughout this pandemic, regardless of where you come from, where your passions lie, what your aspirations are, we can all relate to one thing, and that is the challenge of mental health. This is something we will be actively attending to this year and working to highlight the strength and vulnerability. And third, reestablish unity throughout our diverse SDSU community. Because there is no one identity that makes up the meaning behind an SDSU student. It is the different cultures, identities, and walks of life that make the SDSU family what it is. But what brings us all together is a sense of pride, a love for the school, and a constant desire to see it made even better. So welcome back. We appreciate all that has passed, are grateful for this moment, and look forward to all that is to come. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Salvador Hector Ochoa, and Ms. Charlotte Ochiki, President of the SDSU Alumni Board of Directors. Provost Ochoa joined SDSU in July 2019 as the university's Chief Academic Officer. He came to us from the University of New Mexico and brings more than 20 years of academic leadership experience. Charlotte Ochiki is Vice President of Programs, Planning and Development for the Education, Instruction, and Operations Department at the Neighborhood House Association, San Diego's largest private nonprofit organization in San Diego County. Charlotte graduated in 2000 with a Master of Arts degree in Public Administration and has been involved with SDSU alumni for 5 years. She is the current president of the SDSU Alumni Board of Directors and is a board member of the Campanile Foundation. Please join me in welcoming Provost Ochoa and Ms. Charlotte Ochiki.
Good morning. San Diego State University is a premier university in large part because of our incredible stellar faculty. Among them are masterful, inspireful teachers, phenomenal researchers, committed and engaged citizens of our university community, passionate leaders of their scholarly disciplines, both nationally and internationally, compassionate servants of our SDSU community, and many who excel in all areas of their professional endeavors. Because of the generous support of the SDSU alumni, each year we're most fortunate to honor one impressive faculty member from each of our colleges and Imperial Valley with the San Diego State University Alumni Distinguished Faculty Award. It is with great pleasure that I stand before you today to recognize remarkable achievements of this year's recipients of the San Diego State University Alumni Distinguished Faculty Award. From the Fowler College of Business.
Growing up in India, there was a focus on the us, if you will, the community, the group. And so that's always been part of my upbringing. When I came here to the US to study, and one of the things that was really, really interesting about this environment is the validation of the I. You know, you can do things, you can really achieve things. The individual's progress was so fascinating to me. It was very energizing. But the we part of the equation is very important, and actually the I cannot exist without the we, right? And so how do we really balance the two has become the focus of my research.
Dr. Shamu Sundramurthy is professor and chair of the management department in the Fowler College of Business, where she served for nearly 2 decades. Dr. Sundramurthy's research centers on the corporate governance of large public companies, social enterprises, and family business.
We collectively see that we amplify the human side of business in a unit as a balance for the financial or the economic perspectives that exist within businesses. So our students really, with their courses, with the focus, really are amplifying the human side of business. I'm very excited about the energy in our department. Mission Valley is happening, so innovation is key. So I see us playing a role there. I see the department, but also Fowler College playing a role there. I see growing even more my leadership skills, you know. And I'm having fun, too, at the stage, leading the unit, you know, and growing as a leader as well.
Dr. Tamu Sundaramurthy. From the College of Education.
Many people, if they look at a blank piece of paper or a blank computer screen, that's terrifying. To me, that's one of the most exciting things that I do in life, is start from nothing and create something really valuable.
Dr. Marjorie F. Olney is a professor in the College of Education and former director of the Psychiatric Rehabilitation Certificate Program, which she created in 2006.
About 20 years ago, I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder. My diagnosis really changed my thinking because all of a sudden I was looking at it as a consumer of services, not a provider of services. I developed a psychiatric rehabilitation program intended to train individuals to work with people who have serious mental illness toward their recovery. And by recovery, I mean the ability to form relationships, to heal relationships with families, and to take advantage of all the really positive things that we all enjoy. I think people will look at somebody with serious mental illness and think to themselves that, you know, that the person is a lost cause. And that's simply not true. There's very, very good research showing that people can and do actually get better, even from severe mental illness. Having curriculum to develop over a period of years allowed me to get into the creativity of developing new programs, new courses, new degrees, and coming up with hopefully better ways to serve this population.
Dr. Marjorie Olney. From the College of Engineering.
Growing up in Brazil and having the dream to become an engineer was that nobody ever questioned my choices. Nobody ever told me that science or math or engineering are not for girls. I never had that in my life, and I always believed that whatever I set myself up to do, I would get to that point.
Dr. Thais Alves is an associate professor in the College of Engineering and the Associated General Contractors Paul S. Roll Chair in Construction Engineering and Management. Dr. Alves's work focuses primarily on lean construction, an holistic approach to construction management that aims to minimize waste and maximize value at all levels of the construction process.
At first, I wanted to be a structural engineer, but I discovered very fast that I didn't want to be in front of a computer the whole day. I don't have a lab on campus. My lab is the construction site, wherever it is, and construction organizations. And I love meeting people and talking to them and knowing about their stories and how they do their work.
Though her research gives her great satisfaction, Dr. Alves's real passion is her students, who, as she puts it, build the world we live in.
I love being around my students, and if only they knew. Engineering, sometimes it's hard. It takes a village, but you should persevere, you should continue, and they go out there and they do amazing things. That's the best job in the world. You help people accomplish their best. And along the way, they change the city. They build things that we need. I mean, what can be better than that? It's amazing.
Dr. Thais Alves. From the College of Health and Human Services.
My father was a World War II pilot and flew B-17s, and he suffered from a severe high-frequency hearing loss as a result of noise exposure. And that contributed to my interest in audiology and my desire to become part of the solution.
Dr. Carol McCursey is a clinical audiologist and a professor in the School of Speech, Language, and Hearing Sciences, where she serves as the director of the Auditory Research Lab.
My research involves the study of perceptual consequences of hearing loss, as well as the physiological impact and the stress this hearing loss produces. We are able to measure the sound a hearing aid is creating in the ear canal of the person, so we get an accurate idea of whether or not it's providing enough amplification for their hearing loss. But we can only do so much correction with hearing aids. The sound of metal shows a man who suffers from a profound hearing loss. So hearing aids can make sounds more accessible, but it can never completely make the signals clear.
And the hearing that you have lost is not coming back.
So it's very important for people to protect their hearing. The thing that really drives me is knowing that we are training students to change lives, that through the treatment we are able to provide people who really rely on hearing for communication, we're able to substantially improve quality of life.
Dr. Carol McCursey. From the College of Professional Studies and Fine Arts.
One of my favorite parts about being a costume designer is that magic moment when I meet with the actress for the first time or when we put on a costume. It is so special to me because a character becomes alive in front of you. And part of it is the actor is held by the costume, and that really helps them transform. They bring so much to me usually in the fitting rooms, and that's where all of the detail work begins. It's a pretty special moment.
Denitsa Bliznakova is a professor in the School of Theater, Television, and Film and the head of costume design and technology. Denitsa's love for the arts began as a child in Bulgaria and blossomed after immigrating to the United States in the 90s.
Right when communism fell down in 1990, that's when my family decided that we were going to immigrate. The worst part about that is I didn't speak English. And so that was quite of a setback. But it was at that school when I found the art department. I could communicate without words. Art, drawing, design became this language. And even now, I tell my students as designers, we should talk less, show more. We're visual artists. so we could communicate through visuals. And I've relied on that for most of my career. When I teach my students, I'll always say, you know, when we read plays, the characters come to life in our minds. They're moving. So I always encourage my students, and I do it for myself, to never imagine a costume being static, but always in movement. And that has to do exactly with what are we trying to achieve. To be, in my opinion, a successful designer, you have to collaborate. So you're working as a group in a team to create a cohesive world. It's getting rid of the my and me and changing it to us, to all of us.
Professor Denitsa Blisnikova. From the College of Sciences.
When I grew up as a kid, Jacques Cousteau was on TV. That was a show a lot of us watched, and you know, how fun that must be to go scuba diving and go in submarines. I think a lot of people have this romantic notion about being a marine biologist, but being a marine biologist is actually a lot of work. It's not glamorous work. It's not what people expect.
Dr. Robert Zeller has been a professor at San Diego State for 20 years and is currently in his fourth year as chair of the Department of Biology.
I'm a molecular biologist by training, but I've always been interested in marine organisms. I've raised octopuses in high school. That's what got me interested in the process of development. My interests now sort of combine those two. In trying to understand the way in which the building blocks are assembled and the way in which those building blocks are used.
Dr. Zeller's primary research has been focused on ascidians, commonly referred to as sea squirts.
Sea squirts are very closely related to ourselves. Humans need to form as embryos. Sea squirts use those genes as well. Because they're a very simple organism, it's much easier to study processes in these animals than in humans. There are labs that have developed sea squirt models of diseases. My lab actually developed a model of Alzheimer's disease and found that we could actually recreate various aspects of the disease progression in these animals within 24 hours. It's the right biological material to really investigate what we're interested in. One of the things I fondly remember growing up are all of the teachers and professors that took an interest in me and my friends over the years. And as a professor at SDSU, that's one of the things that I've also strived to do, is to give undergraduates and graduate students opportunities. And whether they go on to professional school, graduate school, I hope that I've been able to instill in them a love of science and a love of learning, and I hope that that's something that they can keep with them throughout their lives.
Dr. Robert Zeller. From SDSU Imperial Valley.
What do you think is most important? What do you love? Why? This is philosophy. The mind and the body are one, and martial arts is a form of embodied consciousness, and it's a form of philosophy and bettering myself that I think is among the most important things I can do.
Dr. Mark Wheeler is a professor in the Department of Philosophy, where he's taught for over 25 years.
I was originally passionate and obsessive about writing poetry. I expressed myself in poetry, but I drenched myself in philosophy. There's certainly an important part of teaching which is about drama, which is about theater. But I try not to make teaching about me. I try to come into the classroom and to serve the students. I think that's what philosophy at its best is all about.
In addition to his teaching, Dr. Wheeler has published a book on the history of philosophy. He serves as the director of SDSU's Institute for Ethics and Public Affairs and is a member of the CSU Academic Senate. He's also actively engaged in the community as president of Compassion for African Villages. Recently, Mark was selected to serve as interim dean for SDSU Imperial Valley.
I love the Imperial Valley. The first time I came out here, I was amazed to find this beautiful campus in the middle of this miracle of the desert. I felt like, oh, this is where I should be. Then Adela de la Torre comes to campus, and finally, San Diego State University is paying the kind of attention to Imperial Valley that it always ought to have. And I look forward to talking with people on the San Diego campus about Imperial Valley and helping them to see what I see, and I hope lure some of you looking at the camera to come out and be with us, because it's a great place to be and it's a great mission. If you didn't come to San Diego State University as a student or as a faculty member or as a staff person, you missed something important. Not that other places aren't great, but we're great.
Dr. Mark Wheeler. Please join me in congratulating all my faculty awardees. We're so pleased to call you colleagues. And now I'd like to welcome President De La Torre back to the podium.
Thank you, Provost Ochoa. It is now truly my honor to announce the recipient of the inaugural SDSU Staff Lifetime Achievement Award. This prestigious award was created to recognize an exemplary staff member who has made significant contributions to the mission of the university throughout their career. In order to be eligible, nominated staff members must have served the university for a minimum of 15 years and received at least 3 letters of recommendation to accompany the nomination. We will now watch a special video highlighting this year's inaugural recipient.
This is 140% of the original sculpture. I gotta say that it's unacceptable that there's cobwebs up here. We definitely gotta do a little maintenance. Can tell we haven't been on campus too much lately. Get to do a lot of different things as alumni director. That was one of them.
Jim Herrick is the Assistant Vice President for Alumni Engagement in the Division of University Relations and Development. With over 35 years of institutional knowledge, Jim volunteered to give our documentary film crew a tour of the campus he loves so much.
Hop in, guys. Pardon me, it's just a golf cart. This is one of these great parts of campus. Did that stop sign apply to us? This is such a fabulous building. Everybody's got great concert experiences, but the basketball has just been so spectacular.
And my first boss, Fred Miller, the athletic director, he would always say, you know, we're taking a walk across campus. And he insisted we walk, and he would remind me that we are so fortunate to work on a college campus.
We gotta say hi to Luis. Hey, Luis, what's your pooch's name?
This is Max.
Hey, Max, great to be on campus. Can we pop in the president's office?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
All right. They didn't always have this gate here, because I would come in and I'd just hop over whatever fence they had here, and they didn't appreciate that I just popped in. Is the president home?
He's not here today.
Normally, Luis would be escorting me out of the office about now. And the idea that I could actually hop over this fence, not only is it currently unrealistic, but it's basically frowned upon, you know.
I look for the opportunities, and a lot of it is just, you know, being on campus and being aware of all the great things going on.
It's a good parking spot, huh? What are you guys looking for?
East Commons.
East Commons. Here, hop in. We'll take you there.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah.
So much.
You're well insured, right? Just kidding.
In 2 years, we will hit the 500,000 mark in terms of number of SDSU alumni. You know, our alumni are everywhere and making a huge impact, availing themselves to the world to make it better. And that feels good to be a part of that.
ITS, they will fix you up. We're gonna just pop in. I'll see if I can rent some speakers for an event coming up in August. I know that guy. You've helped me out before recently. What do you got today?
We got today fruits or vegetables?
Or... What about speakers?
Speakers?
Yeah.
This way.
This way.
When you ask people at San Diego State for help, they will help you. And similarly, when people ask you for something, you help them.
And you're a perfect example of a guy on campus who just is willing to help us do our jobs around here.
Well, like our director said, we're here to help.
There seems to be this spirit of cooperation among the people who work at the university, and it's a beautiful thing.
This is one of my favorite places on campus. I mean, who doesn't have an impulse every now and then just to get up from their work and go bowling? Oh, hello. Can we come in and look around? Oh, thank you so much.
How's it going?
Good. You're working.
Yeah.
You know, every place we've been to this morning, they've kicked us out of.
Oh, so, they don't know who you are.
Yeah, well, you know, or they do.
Yeah. Do you want to throw a ball?
Yeah.
What weight do you want?
Medium.
Okay.
You've got to produce. You've got to get work done. You've got to work with everybody to do your job. But I believe that it can be fun while you go.
To be an excellent bowler, you've got to focus on the pins. You've got to try to knock them down. You've got to give it that left to right spit. Here's a sneak preview of what excellent bowling looks like. It's just that easy. I'm gonna rethink my career.
If I can, I wanna stop and just absorb how everyone else is enjoying this campus.
Really, it's spectacular. Look at that, East Commons, Hardy Tower, Love Library.
People ask me about the job of being the alumni director, and it's being aware of what alumni are thinking and what they care about, and to be ready for big events. You know, when I just think about how lucky I am to have been able to live off the energy of this campus, I'm so fortunate. What a great way to have spent 35 years.
wonderful tribute to Jim and his countless contributions to the university. Before I invite Jim to accept his award, I want to share some words from those colleagues who nominated him. Jim's history and experience at SDSU are unparalleled. His boundless knowledge of dates, events, traditions, and individuals from the university's storied past helps us grow and build a stronger foundation for our future. Without Jim's expertise, appreciation of how the university works, and endless connections, we would not have been able to save any of the university's 8 historic murals, hold successful public events for the anniversaries of Aztec Bowl, President John F. Kennedy's 1963 visit to campus, and the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr.'s 1964 visit to campus, or plan for the university's impending 125th anniversary in 2022-23. I'm not the first person to note that with Jim on your team, goals become attainable, collaboration runs smoothly, and projects simply become far more fun. Everyone who interacts with Jim is touched in a positive way. He knows how to bring light to dark situations with his humor, how to fix a problem when plans go sideways with his clever way of thinking, how to read a crowd and interact with any type of personality, how to strategize to maximize time and resources in an efficient way to promote a greater outcome. Jim's contributions to the university's Department of Athletics and SDSU alumni, as well as university relations and development, have provided the necessary foundation for SDSU to grow, thrive, and rise in stature and reputation in the ranks of higher education nationally and internationally. He has been integral in securing some of the most transformative gifts to the university, is a committed partner to our SDSU veterans, connects Aztec alumni across the country, and is a glue that keeps the morale of our entire division together. One of the qualities that makes Jim so special, and in my opinion so effective, is his willingness, perhaps even eagerness, to share and outright give credit to others when it is truthfully due to him. He is a doer, not a self-promoter. Finally, and most importantly, Jim is our friend. In fact, he is a true friend to all who work at the university or are associated with SDSU. He is fun, authentic in his joy, and through his leadership by example, gives permission for us all to enjoy what we do in our work and celebrate our achievements. This is our opportunity to celebrate his many decades of contributions to SDSU. Congratulations, Jim, on this much-deserved award.
So congratulations again to all of our award recipients. And you've done it. You've gotten through convocation. I want to say a sincere thank you for joining this morning with us here or online. We hope that you go and grab our grab-and-go lunches in the courtyard. Not if you're online. My apologies. And thank you again for being here. I wish you a great year, the best year. And go Aztecs.